Bye.
Hey, wait a minute.
I shook off my husband and jumped into the car. My husband spread his arms in front of the car as if to say,
If you were going to go, you'll have to knock me down first.
This guy is such a narcissist. I had noticed it before, but I didn't know it was this bad. I rolled down the car window, and my husband turned his teary eyes toward me. Take care. I stepped on the gas and took off. I'm Leah. I am 30 years old, and I work for a trading company. The company recently introduced remote work. Thanks to that, I can smoothly do my work from home every day. On the other hand, my husband Wade, whom I married 3 years ago, works in sales. Therefore, it is impossible for him to work from home, and he goes to work at the same time every morning. I met my husband through a mutual friend, and he is a divorced man who works for one of the famous enterprises in town. When I first met him, I was impressed by his youthful and refreshing appearance, which made me think he wasn't in his 40s. Our hometowns are both in the countryside, and we can't go back there so often. But during the holiday season, we always go to my husband's parents' house together.
Speaking of which, on our next visit, don't forget to prepare something nice for my mom, okay?
I'm dissatisfied with my husband's words. He takes it for granted that I will prepare souvenirs for his parents every time. It was the same the last summer. The problem is not that he leaves everything to me. Just as he has parents, I have parents who have taken good care of me. However, my husband only cares about his own parents, which creates feelings of inequality and dissatisfaction. Since we got married, he has never visited my parents' house, and he never talks about them either. In the midst of all this, he even leaves it to me to prepare souvenirs for his parents.
So, what did you get for my parents as a souvenir this time?
As soon as he got home from work, he asked me. I got a box of associate chocolates.
Huh. I think fruits would be better.
Why? Your parents really like sweets, don't they? I'm being careful not giving them the same thing every time, so it's not a problem.
Well, I don't like chocolate.
Huh? Whether you like it or not doesn't matter. This is a souvenir for your parents, I was thinking to myself.
But I can't eat chocolate. I wish you had bought something we could all share.
I know.
Why don't you send that chocolate to your parents? And you go shopping again tomorrow. This time, get something better, okay?
Although my husband usually doesn't care about my parents at all, he mentioned their names this time. Of course, I know he doesn't really care about my parents. And now he wants me to go shopping again. That's not fair. I have a job too. I bought the souvenir for his parents during my lunch break. Shouldn't be the first word be thank you instead. I was really mad.
I'm not going.
What?
Why?
Because I have work to do.
But you're working from home, right?
You have time, don't you? You are the one who works in sales and goes out, right? Isn't it easier for you to go and buy something then?
What? I wouldn't do something like that. It's unprofessional.
Really? When we were dating, you left work several times to come and see me, didn't you?
Well, at that time, I was young and...
I don't know what kind of excuse that is, but
anyway. I won't go shopping anymore. If you don't like what I chose, then go buy something yourself.
Okay, okay.
Then chocolate is fine. My husband was angry and trying to rush to his room.
Hold on a second.
What? What is it?
Don't you have something to tell me?
Huh?
How about saying thank you?
What are you talking about? I don't need to thank you for buying something I don't like.
Okay, then. How about saying I'm sorry for your insensitive behavior of telling me to send unwanted things to my parents?
What the hell, Leah? I'm not going to say anything like that.
Since we got married, he has never expressed gratitude or apologies to me. He used to be someone who could casually say those things before we got married. But it seems that he can't say them anymore now that we're married. He must have been hiding his true nature all along. I regret that I didn't see through it. My husband is a divorcee, so my parents were worried when we got married. But they supported my decision and sent me off happily. Now I understand why he got divorced. He lacks consideration for others. He completely underestimates my remote work job. My husband thinks that I'm just lousing around at home, but it's not true. My workload hasn't changed at all. It's just the location changed to my house. He doesn't even try to understand that.
I thought you were an obedient woman. Don't disappoint me.
What? What did you say?
I said that you would listen to me. And that's why I married you.
Are you serious?
Wow. My husband and I have a 10-year age difference. There are times when he looks down on me. But even with the age difference, we are still a married couple. I don't intend to stay quiet about things I can't compromise on.
Well, you know what? I'm disappointed in you too. I might have reached my limit with you.
What do you mean by that?
How did it sound to you? When I answered like that, my husband looked at me and chuckled.
Leah, marriage is about supporting each other and living together. You can't give up after just 3 years of marriage, okay?
He's really the narcissistic type, isn't he? He's probably thinking something like, am I saying something cool?
How can you talk about supporting each other?
You actually gave up yourself, didn't you?
Your last marriage didn't even last 2 years, didn't it?
It was all my ex-wife's fault. You don't know anything.
Well, I know, because I'm married to you, and I'm sure you have problems. I heard from my husband before the reason for his previous divorce was because his ex-wife cheated on him. He said she didn't even do any housework, and my husband did it all of it. But now I can tell that it's definitely a lie. Because my husband has never done any housework since we got married. He even leaves his dirty clothes lying around. Eats the food I cook while looking at his phone or TV without expressing any gratitude or appreciation for it. He doesn't even wash the dishes himself. Aside from ex-wife's cheating, it's an absolute lie that he did all the housework.
Don't act all high and mighty toward me.
And then my husband kicked the chair hard and ran into his room. I wonder if it's over. I can only imagine a future where we break up. He, who used to be kind, is nowhere to be found. Everything had already been piling up for the past 3 years. The dust had piled up into a mountain,
and caused a landslide. The next day, when I woke up, my husband didn't want to face me and had already gone to work. And on this day, an irreparable event happened to us. My phone rang in the evening just after finishing work. It was a call from my mother. When I answered the phone, she told me an unbelievable fact. My father suddenly collapsed at work and was taken to the hospital. My father, who had a pre-existing heart condition, was in critical condition. I quickly hang up the phone, grabbed my car keys, phone, and wallet with my driver's license, and headed towards the entrance. Then I ran into my husband there.
Have you reflected on what happened yesterday?
You're in my way.
Huh?
My father collapsed at work. I'm heading to the hospital right now, so move aside.
I'm not moving. What are you thinking?
Just move aside.
Who should you prioritize here? Me, right?
Then my husband grabbed my shoulders with both hands and shook me roughly.
Your father has your mother, so he'll be fine. You're going to make dinner for me now. Got it?
While he was making what he thought was a kind smile, he peered into my face and laughed. Let go! Let go! I bit my husband's arm as hard as I could.
What? What are you doing?
This is violence. You started it. You grabbed my shoulders and shook me roughly too. Just move aside, would you?
If you really need to go, then fine. So you were just going to leave me alone like this, huh? Then, you don't need to come back. It'll be a relief if I can save some living expenses.
This seemed to be my husband's sore loser line.
Yeah, whatever.
I don't plan on coming back anyway. Well, take care. I shook off my husband's grip and jumped into the car. Then, my husband stood in front of a car with his arms spread out, as if to stop me.
If you are going to go, you'll have to knock me down first.
This guy is such a narcissist. I had noticed it before, but I never imagined it was this bad. I opened the car window, and my husband looked at me with teary eyes. Take care. I stepped on the gas, and my husband let out a small scream and shrunk to the ground. Ignoring him, I drove to the hospital. When I arrived, my father had regained consciousness. He had a subarachnoid hemorrhage and had to be hospitalized for a while before switching to outpatient care because of the possibility of a second rupture. I explained the situation to my company and took 3 days off to accompany my parents. Then I returned to my husband's house and placed divorce papers on the table.
Leo, what are you trying to do?
You don't want me to come back here anymore, right? So, there's only one thing to do, and that's to get a divorce.
No, I won't accept that.
Huh? It doesn't matter if you accept it or not. I'm going to file for divorce.
Then I'll sue you for damages.
I don't care. As long as I can leave you. By the way, did you have any guests? Then there was a loud noise coming from my husband's room. What was that noise just now?
I didn't hear anything.
I stood up, and my husband stood in front of the room.
This is my private space.
Ignoring him, I opened the door to the guest room with all my might. What? Oh my God! In front of me was an unfamiliar naked woman.
This is a thief!
This is the first time in my life I've seen a naked thief. Hilarious! Yes, I caught my husband cheating on me right on the spot. I immediately took a photo of the scene as evidence with my smartphone. After I caught him with the evidence, he paid me alimony and we got divorced. My life has been stress-free since the divorce. According to my ex-in-laws, my ex-husband resigned from his company on his own accord. The woman he cheated on me with turned out to be his boss's wife. In fact, she had been seducing him for a while, but they had never crossed the line until that day. However, the day before, my ex-husband had a fight with me and was angry, so he took her to our house to vent his frustration. It was a perfect timing for me, the wife, to witness my husband's first infidelity. Thanks to that, the divorce went smoother than expected. So I'm a little grateful to my ex-husband for that. Of course, I also demanded alimony from his mistress, and she used her husband's money to secretly pay me. But when her husband, my ex-husband's boss, saw the payment history, he confronted her, and the affair became known to my ex-husband's boss. It seems like it became a big rumor within the company, and my ex-husband couldn't bear the atmosphere, so he resigned. He was also almost disowned by his parents, so he had no one to rely on, and is now barely making ends meet, doing odd jobs. I truly believe in karma. After my father was discharged from the hospital, I returned to my parents' house and continued working. I had been trying to stay strong in front of my ex-husband, but I'm honestly quite hurt. I'll keep working hard until the day wounds heals. And when someone nice and caring comes into my life again, I'll take the plunge without fear.